tell you how the hunt is on to nab the four accused of molesting a Kerala actor. A woman can be said to be socially and economically empowered, and yet she gets targeted by molesters. But who really emboldens these perverts? Is it our netas who provide covert as well as the face example? BJP-backed Maharashtra MLC Prashant Paricharak, remember, had said that wives of soldiers are unfaithful. Well, the objectionable comments coming up even as our soldiers lay down their lives for the country. And today, rape accused MLA from UP, remember, he was a minister in Akhilesh Yadav government as well, has pointed fingers at the Prime Minister who had recently slammed him publicly. What then explains that netas insult our soldiers and rape accused netas who should be standing trial make public speeches. Aren't these netas public enemy number one?
रावत में कौन सभी प्रजा मतला सैनिक लास्ट को आदर अच्छी बाय कोई भी बाहर की नौती तब तारीख की तुझे बाय करों मुर्गा डाला वर्ष भर तो मैं कहाँ पर गिरे रहा नस्तो इतने पे इतने पहले वक्त लोग मुझे काय जाने काय जाने कि मैं तो मारा पोर जाना तो तेरे राजकार
There's no damage which has been done. If he's punished adequately, then means society is with all these people who have been agonized by his comments. I think Fadnavis is a very sensible person, and because he is in the middle of an election, I think the polling date is perhaps now over tomorrow. The first thing I'm going to do is call him up and say, pass a resolution unseating him.
उन्होंने जो statement दिया है, बहुत दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण ऐसा statement है, जिसकी मैं कड़ी निंदा करती हूँ। इस तरह से उन्होंने बात नहीं करनी चाहिए थी। हमारे देश के जवान जो है, वो सीमा पर रहते हैं, बहुत त्याग भी करते हैं और इसी त्याग में उनका उनके फैमिली का भी बहुत सहभाग होता है, वो भी त्याग करते हैं तभी उस वो जवान सीमा पे देश के लिए लड़ सकते हैं। ये बात करने का उनका तरीका बिल्कुल ठीक नहीं है और इसका कॉग्निशन हमने लिया है।
Well, this is a call-in show. We are asking you, the viewers, to connect with us directly here on NewsX. We are going to give you our platform to air your views and opinions on the shame that our netas seem to be bringing to India. Well, with that, let's introduce you our guests. One, we have Pramila Nesargi, an activist as well as a lawyer. Also, Brigadier Mahalingam joins us, a defense analyst. Well, Ms. Nesargi, if I can come to you first, it's shameful that these netas, who are themselves accused of rape, accused of several such unmentionable crimes, are the ones who are interestingly and ironically targeting our jawans, jawans who've been literally making the ultimate sacrifice, jawans who are fighting the highest battlefields of the world. They are the ones on their target, and let's not forget they are the ones legitimizing crimes and rapes against women then. Ms. Nesargi.
Yes, please. Tell me.
Ma'am, that question Hello? Was for you. Do you think by these reckless Hello? Statements being made Hello? By our netas that they have legitimized crime and also untold misery for the women of India?
The question is, you know, in no one in the world has got any right to speak about a soldier. They are our saviors. They save the country. And we nothing should be uttered which will, I mean, spoil their morale. This is one of the statements which will definitely affect. I do not know why these people are uttering such words, and I do not know whether they mean it or they deliberately do it or they have no sense of what to speak and what not to speak. Especially the soldiers of this country are greater people, and they are the ones who save our country, and we must be grateful to them. And on the other hand, we must always boost their image and then tell them what they have been doing good. And anything, any word uttering which will discourage them and spoil them is unwarranted, and they must be condemned wholesale.
Well, in fact, we are going to get in Brigadier Mahalingam as well. But before that, this is a call-in show. So several of our viewers have been calling in. They all want their voices to be heard. Simple question we are asking you. What is the strictest possible punishment which ought to be meted out to such netas who are setting a wrong example? First of all, we have Kalpana Ravi who is joining us from Mumbai. Go ahead, Kalpana. What do you think?
Good evening, Meghna. This is the most shameful, and I think our leaders, our netas, are getting shameful by the day. Every day they have to say something or the other, either it is to insult a woman. Now the new thing is insult the army left, right and center. I really don't know what punishment. I send them to Siachen and let them live there for 15 days. Maybe that would be the answer. And do they think also what they are talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Would you be able to live peacefully over here if the jawans were not guarding us?
Absolutely.
Or fighting for us? I mean, what kind of stupid statements? I mean, what do you do? Make them stand in public and look for them is what I would say.
And all of them are holding very responsible public offices as well when they make statements such as this. It's a wrong message which is being sent out. Well, Brigadier, if I can come to you, an army man, a jawan who's out there on the borders, guarding us day in and day out, ready to make the ultimate sacrifice, get such kind of malicious statements being made against him and his family. Do you think this is going to affect the morale or do you think that the army men really know better?
It is absolutely disgraceful and unacceptable, leave alone army, for any sort of society or group of people.
Absolutely.
And he is not an ordinary man. He is an MLC, totally unbecoming of the position that he holds today. And secondly, more disgraceful is the fact that he is a MLC from the BJP. Today afternoon sometime when I got to know about this story, I thought the BJP will sack him first by another 2 hours' time. And that is what I expected of a national party which claims to lead this country ahead. And I'm afraid they have done nothing. They are waiting for what God alone knows. Let's understand one thing. This MLC, as an MLC, has public dealings.
Mm-hmm.
And what he said reflects his sort of perverted mind that he has, and he is unfit to interact with the people, especially in a place where men, women, children would come across and seek favors and things like that for him.
Absolutely.
Therefore, what I feel is BJP, if it has not yet initiated action, it must initiate action now to sack this man. And he cannot be allowed to continue in his office any longer, because if BJP doesn't do that,
mm-hmm.
it will be seen as a political party which accepts moral degradation of its political class.
Whom does the onus really lie on? That's the big question, to ensure that loose-mouthed netas such as this are brought in line, that they receive the adequate punishment. Well, that's the question we are asking you, the viewers. What should be the punishment for netas such as this? Several of our viewers have been connecting with us on those numbers at the bottom of your screens. There is Raj Shiva who's joining us from Chennai. Go ahead, Raj. What do you think?
Yes, it is like this. This type
See,
of
they must
behavior.
Be told, you know, they must be the role models.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, Raja. Miss Nesargi, I'll just come back to you. Raj, go ahead.
This type of a behavior cannot be dealt with by one answer.
Mm-hmm.
It's a multiple problem. From time to time, various people all over, not only in India,
mm-hmm.
we saw the recent elections, there will be people who behave like this. We have to take certain steps. Such person should be first called upon to resign immediately
mm-hmm.
and go for a psychiatric test also.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from that, in all our public institutions, schools, everywhere, some sort of an education, the time has come to respect women. Women must be given a lot of respect.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, there are so many cases taking place that it's time we conduct a very big awareness campaign and put women where they deserve to be.
You've made a very relevant point. It's not just about punishing leaders such as this, but the entire social fabric needs to change. The very mindset of India needs to change. We need to educate our sons better and definitely our neighbors better. And they need to ensure that there is some kind of sensitivity that is inculcated in them. In fact, another one of our viewers, Anil Deekshit, is calling us from Gwalior. Go ahead, Anil. What do you think?
Yeah. I will point out 2 points. First is legitimacy of something. These people, advocates, or MPs, MLAs, or anybody who is not sitting in a judicial proceeding or in parliament or in a legislature,
right,
has no legitimacy. His statement has no legitimacy. That you should forget. You should not legitimize it by asking whether it is legitimate or not. Second,
I think there are no two ways about it. It is not legitimate and it is something that all of us must introspect. Because is this guy representing the very inherent mindset, the misogyny which is inherent in our society, which is why it's important for us to discuss it and also know that the society will not tolerate people such as this. Thank you so much for joining us, Anil, with your views. In fact, there's also Rajni who's calling us from Mumbai. Go ahead, Rajni. What do you think?
Yeah, this is really absurd, you know. I mean, I really feel, how can you tell about, people like this? It's really, really, you know, how they put all their lives in the border, and how can you tell about the people's lives simply sitting here in a nice city? And I feel like, unless, you know, you don't respect the army wives and their families, how do you expect everyone to look? Whenever it is, there is a need, people come running to the army people.
Absolutely.
Why is it like that? You know, it's really, really absurd, you know. Mm-hmm. People sitting in, these political people, they sit there and they enjoy their life. And then they take an opportunity. Why don't somebody ask them to go and at least see there, you know, how
right.
people suffer. They give their lives and, you know, simply talking on a phone to just to take the vote is... it's really painful.
Absolutely. And it's unfortunate. Not only have they disrespected women, they've also now disrespected our jawans. That's the low level that politics, unfortunately, has really stooped to. Ms. Nesalgi, a quick question. And this is something that Brigadier has also said as well. Who really needs to act? Should there be a law against people's representatives or MLCs as well as to what they can or can't say, considering they are setting the example? Or does the onus lie on the party itself? Even if they aren't punished by law, why isn't the party punishing them?
See, before assuming their office as MLC, you know, they take the vote.
Right.
Vote that they are obeying the constitution and the rules and the laws that is made under the country.
Right.
If they fail to do that, if they fail to continue the constitution and the oath they have undertaken, that means they have broken the constitution oath. In other words, they are unfit to continue in that office.
Right.
See, there should be a code of conduct to such people and they must be told what to speak and what not to speak and what is the margin under what, or to how long they can speak. First thing they must learn is the dignity of women is guaranteed under the constitution and they cannot violate it. And if they do anything which will violate the dignity of the constitution, dignity of the woman, then they must be told, here is the word that you uttered which is unfit and unbecoming of an MLC and you are unfit to continue in the office, and you must tell him that this is not the way you must talk, and the higher up, whoever it is, they must take disciplinary action against him and they must be warned. And if they repeat it, whether they must continue to work as an MLC is another thing which must be looked into. That's why we always ask for right to recall them.
Right.
If only we had a right to recall the representatives, then the public could call upon them and call them back. That itself is not guaranteed. The high time, this is an instance where we can agitate and say, the public must have a right to recall their own representatives if they violate the constitution. I think that will serve the purpose.
Well, absolutely. That's a good enough suggestion. But the big question is, how long before right to recall gets implemented? And more importantly, will legislators ever pass a bill to that effect? Well, do stay on with us, Ms. Nesalgi. Several of our viewers have been calling in. There's Ponnappa as well as Geeta, both of them calling in from Bengaluru. Ponnappa, you go first. What do you think?
Yeah. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
We boast of a constitution which has insulated rogues like him. He must be talking out of his personal experience. He can't generalize like this. Mm-hmm. He has to be just like George Fernandez sent some of the babus to the to Kargil. And
it's his mindset.
He should also be sent there. He should see what is the situation. How can he say this?
Absolutely. People who are completely cut off from reality, MLCs such as this, who are completely cut off from reality, don't even know the kind of sacrifices that our jawans, our braves have been making for us in order to keep their motherland safe. They are the ones making such irresponsible statements. All of this, of course, in public. Thank you so much, Ponnappa, for joining us. There's also Geeta, who's joining us from Bengaluru. Go ahead, Geeta.
Yeah, this man should realize that he and his family is safe. It's only because of the army that they are protecting us every day and night. It's only because of them we can be safe. So he should know that. He cannot talk any rubbish. He looks like a rapist himself. Mm-hmm. He should be punished. He should be sent to the border without any protection, without anything, and see for himself what the hardships that they face. We pray every day for our army, armed forces, every day, for their safety.
Absolutely.
And for their families. But this man has got no sense. He doesn't know that he's only safe.
Absolutely.
Because of them. He should be punished and he should be sacked immediately.
He ought to be sacked, but unfortunately his party is still staying mum. Before we slip into a short break, of course, this is going to be a half an hour show. Keep your phone calls coming. But a quick word from Brigadier. Now, Brigadier, it's quite interesting. Several of these people who've been calling us, they all say that people such as this MLC ought to be sent to Siachen. They ought to know the kind of sacrifices. Do you think it's important for us to remember the kind of sacrifices which our jawans are making and to remember the kind of loose words coming out from netas who are completely cut off from reality, quite clearly?
I agree that these people need to understand that the soldiers sacrifice. But apart from the soldiers, as an individual, as a leader, you see, you must understand that the political parties today go in for an election and sort of get into a leadership role.
Right.
If they are in a leadership role, they have to sort of lead the people, show the way for the people. And if you have MLCs and leaders of this variety, how can this country expect to change the mindset of the people?
Absolutely.
We are definitely not going to improve with this kind of leadership there. So it is without a law, there is a duty, there is a sort of a bounden duty on the part of the political parties to see that their leadership, that their members, that the people who work for them have certain moral courage, certain moral conduct, and certain standards. You cannot have this type of gutter politics getting into the country and spoiling, vitiating
Absolutely.
The entire atmosphere. No one, leave alone a soldier, no one is going to like or sort of appreciate this sort of a behavior, and that too by a MLC. And that of a leading national party, the BJP.
Absolutely. That's a very relevant point, because if the BJP refuses, if the party refuses to act against such sexist netas and netas who have been insulting the jawans, at the end of it, if you are not condemning it, then you are also tacitly supporting it. Well, this discussion is going to continue.
They have got to sack him.
Sack him.
Yes.
Not even condemnation, not just mere words will cut it. They need to sack this man. Well, this discussion, as well as all our viewer call-ins, are going to continue on the other side of a short commercial break.